So dear students, today we are going to do grammar topic, subject verb agreement. After that your syllabus will be over. Okay, writing skills, all writing skills are done, literature also done. In grammar only one topic was left, that was subject verb agreement. So let's continue with that. Only last topic of grammar, subject verb agreement. So what is basically subject verb agreement? Okay, to understand this concept, just imagine that you are going to speak any of the sentence. You take any of the subject. Subject can be I, you, we, they, plural, he, she, it, singular. And with that you have to apply verb according to rules. Okay, this verb should agree with the subject, and this is known as subject verb agreement. Clear? For example, subjects we have I, you, we, they, and plurals. With that we use verb first form in the case of present indefinite. And if your subject starts with he, she, it, and singular, then what do we use? Verb first form plus S or ES. This is the basic rule that I have discussed with you. Okay, and we follow always these kinds of rule, that whatever the tenses we have, present indefinite, past indefinite, future indefinite, all the tenses we follow. But in subject verb agreement there are certain rules that you have to follow. All these rules I am going to discuss with you, in which you will come to know that how verb agrees with a subject. Okay, for that you should know the tenses, and we have done tenses so many times, so keep all the tenses in your mind. Okay, now let's start subject verb agreement. So the very first rule that I am going to discuss with you about subject verb agreement is, you all should have grammar books with you, because we will be solving grammar exercise also. Okay, so bachche now listen. So the very first rule that I am going to take, that is, when your subject is composed of, when your subject is composed of two or more singular nouns. For example, Ram and Sita, Radha and Shyam. Okay, so when these are there, okay, two persons are there, then what verb will be used? Which verb will be used? Plural. Plural verb will be used. For example, I take Ram and his friends. Ram and his friends dash on leave today. Now tell me which verb will be there. Ram and his friends, two nouns are there, two nouns are there. So what will be its answer? Subject. This is called subject. Ram and his friend, this is called subject, and this subject is composed of two or more singular nouns. So what will be the verb? Yes, it will be are. Ram and his friends are on leave today. Clear? Ram and his friends are on leave today, so it will be connected, it will be used with are. Clear bachche? Am I clear? Okay. Now let's. So you just look at these rules. There is no need to write down. Only look at these rules. Try to understand it fully. When subject is composed of two or more singular noun, it will be considered. Which verb will be used? They will be used plural verb. Clear, bache? So this was the first rule. Ram and Shyam, Ram and his friends. Okay, teacher and all the students. Okay, so in this way it will be done. Now I'm going to take second example. Lakshya is raising hand. Bache, you type your answer in chat box. There is no need to raise hand. See, if we have two singular noun. Now don't get confused. Now again two singular noun are given, but they are referred to a single thing. The first rule that I have discussed with you, when there were two or more than two nouns, you have taken R. Okay, but now the thing is, we have two singular verbs, and these two singular verbs, they are referring to a single thing. Two singular verbs, they are referring to a single thing. Singular noun like Lakshya and Sumit, okay, Rahul and Rohit, any noun can be there, any person can be there. So when we have two singular verb and they are referring to a single thing, keep, bache, keep this point in your mind. They are referring to a single thing. For example, if I say bread and butter, so bread and butter, two nouns are there, but they are referring to a single thing. Okay, so what verb will be used? Is or are? Tell me. Bread and butter dash the food they can eat. Now in this case, whether we have two nouns, but they will be considered singular. They will not be considered are plural, because students, they commit this mistake. They think two nouns are there, these are joined by using and. Let's take are. No, bache, two nouns are there, they are used using and, but they are referring to a single person. So single is. So bread and butter is the food they can eat. Is will be there. Clear, bache? Bread and butter is the food they can eat. For example, if I say rice and curry dash my favorite dish. Rice and curry dash my favorite dish. So what will be the answer? Rice and curry is. Rice and curry is my favorite dish. Clear, bache? Rice and curry is my favorite dish. Because two things are there, rice and curry, two things are there, but they are referring to one. It means they both the things are considered one. Clear, bache? Now these were two rules that I have discussed with you. Now start rule number third. Now what do rule number third says? Okay. When it is used with each or every, most of the people commit this mistake. Each and every, it is your noun, it is your subject. So when such kind of subject is given, each or every, what will be there? Is or are? Tell me. Which verb will be considered there with each and every? It will be considered singular verb. Don't get confused for that. For example, each of you will be, each of you is absent today in offline class. Okay, every student is supposed to submit their notebook. So with every and with each, I am using word is. I'm not using are because they are taken as a singular. So when such kind of fill-ups are asked in your paper, don't get confused. With each and every, we are supposed to use is. We are not supposed to use are. Is this concept clear, bachche? Tell me. If you have any doubt up to this, you can ask me. Clear? Shall I move further? Okay, now take one example. Every parent and child dash present on PTM. Every parent and child dash present on PTM. Yes, every parent and child was present. Now we will not write down here verb. Whether it is a parent, whether it is child, these are joined by using and, but every word is used. So when we have every word, it means every word is used for a parent also, every word is used for a child also. And when we have been given every word, we have been given each word, so it will be considered was. It will be considered singular, and in singular we use was or is. But if it will be plural, then we will be using were or are. But here we will be taking it as a singular. Clear, bachche? Am I clear with you? Now I'm going to move to next rule. Bachche, keep all these rules very, very carefully in your mind. Okay, listen explanation carefully. Now, next rule we have is, for example, each, every, this rule I have discussed with you. Suppose many, a, not only many, many, a, everyone, everybody, no one, nobody. When we have been given these things, each, every, many, a, everyone, everybody, nobody, somebody, someone, somebody, someone, in all the cases the subject will be considered singular. The subject will be considered singular. So words each, every, many, a, everyone, everybody, anybody, anyone, nobody, somebody, someone. Okay. For example, everyone dash the truth. Everyone dash the truth. So it is no or it is knows. Tell me. Everyone dash the truth. It will be no or it will be knows. Hurry up. Only Janvi knows the answer. Only one girl knows the answer. What about others are taking rest? If you will not participate, bachche, how will I come to know that you are listening to me or not? Okay, so many students are now participating. they are typing in chat box. I want maximum participation. I'm reading names also so that I will come to know which are my good students, attentive students. It means explanation is clear to them. So, shall I announce the names? Okay, very good. So everyone will be considered singular. So with that, what will be used? It will be used knows. Okay, everyone knows the truth. Everyone, this thing will be taken singular. When nobody, somebody, such kind of subjects are there. So we will be considering it as a singular. Clear? Now I'm going to move to next rule. Next rule we have, when two subjects are joined, two subjects are joined using either or neither nor, either or neither nor, okay, then we will consider it. Tell me, plural or singular? Tell me, when two subjects are joined using either or neither nor, so we will be considering it as a singular or as a plural? Hurry up, tell me. We will be considering it as a singular. Yes, we will be considering it as a singular. Clear? For example, either you or your sister dash going to enjoy the party. Either you or your sister is going to enjoy the party. Either you or your sister is going to enjoy the party. Clear? Neither she nor he dash present today. Neither he nor she dash present today. So it will be, answer will be yes. Because we are taking one person, either you or your sister. It means singular. So with that we will be using is. Neither you nor your sister is going to enjoy the party. So we are going to write down is. Clear, bachche? Am I clear with you? So this rule is clear with you? Okay. Now next rule we have, either or, neither nor. Okay. Then it will be agrees with the subject near to is. Okay. For example, when either or neither nor is given and we have given plural. Like we have given two subjects are given. Okay, subject one and subject two. So the verb will agree with the nearest subject. So what would be the nearest subject? This, not this. For example, either you or your cousins dash coming today. Now here if you have to put is or are, what you are going to use? Because here verb will agree with the nearest subject. So what is the nearest subject? To your cousins. It is a nearest subject. So here we will be using either you or your cousins. Here verb will agree with the nearest subject. And the nearest subject is your cousins. Clear, bachche? क्लियर बेटा? ओके, नाउ आफ्टरवर्ड्स आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस नेक्स्ट रूल. नेक्स्ट रूल वी हैव इज दैट व्हेन योर सब्जेक्ट इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन, व्हेन योर सब्जेक्ट इज अ कलेक्टिव नाउन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आर्मी, क्लास, टीम, क्योर, ऑल दीज आर कलेक्टिव नाउन. सो विद कलेक्टिव नाउन, नो डाउट आर्मी इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ सो मेनी सोल्जर्स, नो डाउट क्लास इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स, बट ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर कंसिडर्ड सिंगुलर. So with that we will be using singular verb. Today my class is attending online only. Okay, team is going to win, Kyor is going to sing a beautiful song, army is approaching towards enemy. So with that army, class, team, Kyor, whatever the collective noun we have, and collective noun definitely it is a group of so many subjects. Okay, so with all these collective noun we are supposed to use singular verb. Clear bachche? Am I clear with you? When we use expressions like with, along with, together, with, along with, together, accompanied by, accompanied by, okay, so with, along with, accompanied by, okay, as well as, in addition to, as well as, in addition to, okay, so in all these cases, okay, if the subject is singular, the verb is singular, but if the subject is plural, the verb will also be plural. If we are using any of the subject by using these words, with, along with, together, accompanied by, as well as, in addition to, so with all that, if subject is singular, then it will be considered singular. If subject is plural, it will be considered clear. Am I clear with you? Subject is singular, it will be considered singular. If subject is plural, it will be considered plural. My voice is not clear. I am speaking so loudly. Other students tell me my voice is clear or not. My voice is clear or not? Text me. Bache, send me message. My voice is clear. One leg. I think it is a network issue. That's why. So this concept is clear. If in any of the subject, with, along with, together, accompanied by, as well as, in addition to, these are used. If subject is singular, the verb is singular, and if the subject is plural, the verb will be plural. Okay, for example, all of your answers, including your answer dash correct, is or are?
Are.
Okay. The actor accompanied by his wife dash traveling to India. The actor accompanied by his wife. We are talking about actor. So it will agree with the first subject. It will agree with the first subject. So we are talking about actor. So with that we will be using is. With actor we will be using is. Clear? Am I clear with you? Okay. Now next we have, when we use noun which appear plural form but are singular in meaning. Some nouns are there which appear plural but actually they are singular. So they will be considered singular. For example, news. See, S is written, it is appearing plural. It appears plural, but actually it is in singular. The news dash, correct. The news is correct. The news is correct. Okay. Civics, mathematics, physics, or S is written, it is appearing plural, but actually these all are singular. Civics is my favorite subject. They are seeming plural, but actually they are singular. Okay, so they will be considered singular. Okay. Now, next rule, we have, see, I'm going to ask you some of the words like trousers, spectacles, S is written. So what do you think? These trousers, spectacles, these are singular or plural? Binoculars. Binoculars. Basically, they are always considered plural because spectacle is a pair of two. Trouser is a pair of two legs. Binocular has two, you can say, holes like that, two lenses. Okay, so trousers, spectacles, binoculars, they are always considered plurals. My spectacles dash lost. Tell me, my spectacles dash lost. Is lost or are lost? My spectacles are lost. Why? It is only one pair. It is one pair, but it has two lens, two glasses like that. Binoculars, my binoculars dash of good quality. My binoculars are of good quality. Okay. Your trousers dash fit you. Your trousers do not fit you. Not does not, do not fit you. Okay. So in this way, they will be considered plural. Now, bachche, our syllabus is done. Our whole syllabus is over of PT3. This grammar topic was left. We are able to complete our syllabus today. So you will be doing practice of this subject verb agreement from your grammar book. Okay. Their exercise A, B and C is given. Exercise A is given on page number 101. So page number 101, exercise A, B and C, you do on your own, you do practice. And during revision time, each and every answer of your grammar book, it will be discussed thoroughly in detail. Okay. So, bachche, from tomorrow onwards, we are going to do revision, and I want my all students should have a separate English notebook for revision. You know what will be the benefit of that? During your exam preparation, you will not find any kind of difficulty. Each and every topic, whatever we have discussed, we have revised in class, whether it is literature, grammar, or writing skill, all the material will be arranged only in single notebook, and it will be easy for you to revise it. Otherwise, during your exam preparation, you have to search here and there different rough notebooks where is English work done. So it's better that you purchase single separate notebook for English revision that I'm going to start from tomorrow. And in between, I will be checking around in your offline class. I will be checking that you people have separate notebook or not. Okay? Okay, bachche. Now get ready for the revision that we are going to start from tomorrow. So thank you, bachche. Thank you and have a nice day.